Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
Item hashtag, SCP-2404 Object Class, Euclid Special Containment Procedures, SCP-2404-1 is contained within a standard humanoid containment cell at Site 17. The floor of the cell has been modified to slope upwards towards its center, and drainage grates have been inserted into the floor around the perimeter of the room, to allow for the removal of water generated by SCP-2404-1. In the event of SCP-2404-1 becoming uncooperative, SCP-2404-1 may be placed in a medically induced coma until the completion of Site 351, at which point it will be relocated there. SCP-2404-2 is contained within a standard humanoid containment cell at Site 66. SCP-2404-2 is to undergo physiological and psychological examinations on a bimonthly basis. Standard meals are sufficient to feed SCP-2404-2, and requests from it to alter the meals given to it are to be rejected. Description: SCP-2404 is the collective designation for two related entities, designated SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2. SCP-2404-1 is an elderly human male of Assyrian descent. SCP-2404-1 has been designated a Class 2I Reality Bender. 2. SCP-2404-1's reality altering capabilities are limited to water, which it is capable of generating, controlling, and destroying, as long as the water remains within 10 meters of it. SCP-2404-1 uses its reality-altering abilities to maintain two jets of water slightly above its shoulder blades. SCP-2404-1 is unable to generate, control, or destroy water with a salt concentration of greater than 35,000 ppm, or water which is a solute in a solution. SCP-2404-1 has not been observed to age while in containment. SCP-2404-1 refers to itself as Enki, and claims to be the Sumerian deity of the same name. SCP-2404-1's fingerprints match those of Elijah, an Assyrian-American man who was declared a missing person 2 years before the discovery and containment of SCP-2404-1. SCP-2404-2 is a humanoid entity, standing approximately 2.25 meters tall and weighing approximately 100 kilograms. SCP-2404-2's anatomy is identical to that of a human with few exceptions. SCP-2404-2's skin is blue-black in color, and is covered by a purple-blue exoskeleton with the exception of joints and sensory organs. SCP-2404-2 possesses a bone crest on its forehead resembling a crown, the majority of which is hollow and serves no apparent purpose. SCP-2404-2 also refers to itself as Enki, and claims to be an extraterrestrial being that visited prehistoric Sumer approximately 8,000 years ago. Examination of SCP-2404-2 reveals that it is genetically human. Discovery: SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2 were discovered in the city of Toronto, Ontario, Canada, after emergency services received a call from multiple people claiming to see a homeless man fighting an alien. Interviews with both SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2 confirm the events that lead up to their containment. SCP-2404-2 had been attempting to gain monetary donations for the purpose of rebuilding its spaceship. SCP-2404-1 had been traveling through the region, and after hearing that SCP-2404-2 referred to itself as Enki, SCP-2404-1 sought it out. SCP-2404-1 confronted SCP-2404-2 over what it believed to be an attempt to impersonate it, leading to a violent altercation. Interview 2404 Aleph, Interview 2404-1 Aleph and Interview 2404-2 Aleph were conducted to determine possible origins for SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2. SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2 were initially unwilling to cooperate with the Foundation, but agreed to be interviewed in exchange for a written translation of The Barton Cylinder 3 and a collection of short stories by the author Isaac Asimov, respectively. Access granted. Interviewed, SCP-2404-1 interviewer, Dr. B. Begin log. Dr. B, okay, let's begin. SCP-2404-1, who are you? SCP-2404-1, I am Enki. Lord of Abundance. Lord of Wisdom, who understands the land. Leader of the Gods. Lord of Eridu. Dr. B, how were you created? SCP-2404-1, I was born to An and Namu. I sealed Ebzu, who is the cosmic waters. I created mankind, and taught your kind civilization. But time passed. New gods replaced the old. My brothers and sisters all faded from being as our worshippers did. I alone remained. I am weak and old, but I am still a god. Dr. B, how was SCP-2404-2 created? SCP-2404-1, that creature? Dr. B, yes, the being you were attacking when we found you. SCP-2404-1, it is false. It calls itself by my title, but it is false. It claims to be from the stars, but it is false. Dr. B, could you elaborate? SCP-2404-1, there was a man. When I found it, there were men helping it. The men gave the creature money and supplies. They must have created the creature as a false depiction of me, or altered an unsuspecting human into it. Dr. B, why would someone do that? SCP-2404-1, I do not know. I can speculate. To grow a movement? To convince men to give up wealth? A false god has many uses. Dr. B, alright, one last thing. Then we'll be done. Your prints are identical to ones from a person who went missing 2 years ago. Are you sure you're telling the truth? SCP-2404-1, I was hoping that would not be discovered. It is true. I was weak when I was without worship. I needed a body. Elijah provided one. He let me in. He let me take him over. I regret it. Dr. B, okay, I think that's enough for today. Thank you, SCP-2404-1. SCP-2404-1, I would like to make a request. I want to apologize to the wife of Elijah. Your organization has many resources. Could you find her for me? Dr. B, we can try. End log. Closing statement. The individuals aiding SCP-2404-2 as described by SCP-2404-1 has not been found. SCP-2404-1's request to meet with the wife of Elijah has been denied. Access granted. Interviewed, SCP-2404-2 interviewer, Dr. B. Begin log. Dr. B, okay, let's begin. SCP-2404-2, could you please tell us where you come from? SCP-2404-2, my name is Enki. I am one of the leaders of an ancient interstellar empire who visited this world long ago, who were worshipped as gods by your kind. I returned here to teach humanity of many things, but my spaceship has crash-landed. Thus, I have to repair it so that I can return to my people. Dr. B, that sounded a little rehearsed, to be honest. Can you explain that? SCP-2404-2, my apologies. That's how I converse with those on the street when I attempt to convert people to my cause. Dr. B, convert them? SCP-2404-2, yes, recruit them into our group. There was a small organization helping me repair my craft. I had taken it upon myself to gain resources of both a monetary and human nature. Dr. B, could you tell us more about the organization that helped you? Any names? SCP-2404-2, I cannot. Not because I do not wish to, I simply do not know the names of my allies. Those who assisted me were extremely secretive. But I can detail how I first encountered them. Dr. B, go ahead. SCP-2404-2, it was right after my ship crashed. My memory was shattered and fragmented. I did not know my own identity. My new friends helped me recuperate, and helped me determine my identity. They showed me the fragments of my broken craft and translated the documents from its computer. Then, we set out to repair it. I was tasked with gaining recruits and donations, as my alien form would be evidence enough to support my claims. Dr. B, where does SCP-2404-1 come from? SCP-2404-2, the man who assaulted me? Dr. B, yes. He claims to be the God Enki in human form. Is he lying? SCP-2404-2, of course he is lying. The very concept of the deity Enki is a warped, distorted cultural memory of my visit to ancient and primitive human society. I am Enki. Dr. B, so what is he? SCP-2404-2, I have a theory, actually. The men who found me, their research was extremely broad. Ancient beings such as myself were their topic of choice, of course, but they branched out into many subjects. One of my allies was researching people who could reshape the fabric of reality with their thoughts. Well, I have been considering the topic, and I have come to a conclusion. This man, he can reshape reality. He delusionally believes he is a god, and thus, he has become one. He is nothing more than a man with an unusually potent god complex. Dr. B, just one more thing, then we'll be done. We've examined the blood sample we took from you when you first arrived here. Genetically, you're identical to a human. SCP-2404-2, of course I am. Does this surprise you? Your kind has been molded and shaped to reflect mine. We made you like us. I am not identical to a human. Humanity is identical to me. Dr. B, thank you for your time, SCP-2404-2. SCP-2404-2, before you go, could I submit a request? I need my craft returned to me. Could you find and repair it? As a favor to me? Dr. B, I'll look into it. End log closing statement. The location of the vehicle described by SCP-2404-2 is currently not known. SCP-2404-2's request to have the vehicle returned to it has been denied. Addendum, on April 4, 2004, two identical messages manifested outside the entrances of Site 17 and Site 66. The messages were in English, and imprinted on clay tablets. The messages are believed to refer to SCP-2404-1 and SCP-2404-2. Access granted. Why are you listening to those idiots? There's only one of me. EA Footnotes 1. A dedicated site designed to contain reality benders. 2. Subtype designation I is the classification for reality benders whose facets are considered to be intentional. See reality benders, classifications and presumed threat levels for a complete definition of this classification. 3. A Sumerian creation myth.